back to MCOC Al Bundy Rules, everybody. Got a Blade 4-minute tutorial today. Before we get into the tutorial, let's take a quick look at some of what he can do. Seeing some great damage, some great bleed. Seeing the ability to stop certain things like the unstoppable there. We're seeing some massive regeneration, and we're going to see much, much more coming up on this tutorial. Nice and quick and to the point, how to get the most out of Blade. First, let's start off with Danger Sense. So he automatically gets against dimensional beams. So very good. So just look at the hashtag dimensional beams as far as on there. With synergies, he can really shine. He can get it against any mystic as well. So it doesn't matter what mystic they are, villain, not villain, dimensional being or not, with that, and that can stop their different abilities. We'll see there. With this synergy with the Ghost Rider, you can get against any villain right there. So with synergies alone, mystics and villains, a huge part of the game. You add in that Stark Spider synergy right there, and you also get some increased potency for those danger effects. So great synergies right here. Recommend using the synergies with Blade as much as possible. He doesn't have to have them, but he does shine with them. Bleed's a big part of Blade. Easiest way to apply it is by parry. You parry, and boom, automatic bleed. And there's a lot of times this can come in handy, but one thing we need to understand is when the bleed is going on for each, you can get 7% of a bar for each stack of bleed. So you get several stacks of bleed through a variety of ways I'm going to show here. You stay close, you can gain power very, very quickly. And you can start spamming specials at certain points as well, which could always be very beneficial. So the more stacks of bleed, the better. Special one, you can get 2 bleed debuffs right there. So in addition to parry, all the specials give bleeds actually. Special 2 gives the most. You usually get several. Here we're going to see about 7 stacks of bleeds or so coming on up. So you'll get multiple. And special 3, you get 3 bleed debuffs. So again, get some bleeds going on. And then stay nice and close, and you can get power just escalate nice and quick. His signature ability is very good. It's not a make or break, but it is going to significantly increase his sustainability. It's that regeneration. We see that regeneration go up rather quickly. This is a max signature Blade, so you will see it go up pretty quick. But we see there, shrugging up debuffs up to 95%. So we'll see with 2 bars of power here as I dash back on this Caltrops node. Then with 3, it goes away almost instantaneously, 95%. So he could be very friendly when it comes to different types of debuff nodes, as long as you have the power up there. Special attacks. The special ones, nothing too fancy, just a couple of bleeds right there. Not one I would focus on too much unless you needed to use it. Special 2 is a great one. You get that additional critical damage. You're also going to get several stacks of bleed and generating a 8% of a bar of power for each bleed inflicted. So you get that. Lots of good stuff there. Special 3. It's okay. You get 3 stacks of bleed and a 70% chance of stun for 3 seconds. So we'll see him going on Juggernaut right there. And then we'll see those nice little smack. Some pretty decent damage as well. Tips for using Blade. Use aura mixture of Blade synergy. So this is a champ I really recommend using synergies. Scout the path, the fights first. See which ones will benefit you the most. If it's mystic heavy, villain heavy, those type of items. These synergies can give danger sense. So some of these harder champs, including ones like MODOK with the auto block, can make this significantly easier as it's going to decrease him doing that. It doesn't just have to be the abilities as far as on the actual champ. It could be on the actual nodes as I showed back on the earlier fight. Tip 2, use as a counter to Thing. For anyone having an issue with Thing, I did a separate video using a 3-star Blade against a 6R3 thing, showing how easy it is just taking off those rock stacks with parries. And the primary is at S2. Get a lot of bleed damage going on and stay close. Get the power going up. So those are going to be the best ways on there to get that good damage just kicking on in. Fourth one is uses great regeneration. You can stay really sustainable with them. Can save you a lot of health pots and rebuys. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to click over on that top left icon that just popped up with a photo. Please click on that to subscribe. Hope you enjoyed the video and hope to see you back for some more.